Hello and welcome to Best of Wednesday on MTG Arena. Today I am playing a deck that I kind of came up with on the fly when one of my friends had the idea. This is Elf Ball. Basically, what we're doing here is we are going to play a lot of elves, we're going to make a lot of mana, and then we're either going to win by overwhelming our opponent with mana sinks, such as Thorn Lieutenant and Elvish Clan Caller, and casting cards we draw off of Beast Whisperer, or sometimes we just kill them with Banefire. This deck can make a lot of mana. So, the reason I think that Elf Ball is interesting, both in general and in Best of One, is because we have creatures that are solid rates and also serve as mana sinks. Growth Chamber Guardian is an elf, it's just a fine creature on its own. And if you've got 10,000 spare mana, this is just a really good thing to be doing. So that's great. Same thing with Incubation Druid, same thing with Thorn Lieutenant. The key is cards that we want to play anyway that are great with tons and tons of mana. The more specific cards that only work in this strategy are Marwyn the Nurturer. You need to be playing a lot of elves for this card to be good, but if you are playing a lot of elves, she is absurd. She gets really huge and makes all the mana in the world. And Beast Whisperer. It's hard to describe how broken it feels once you get one or two of these down and you're just chaining elves, but this is one of the weaker individual cards, because if you have this and nothing else, it doesn't really do anything. And then finally, a couple just, I think of them as rate cards to fill out the deck, are Steelleaf Champion. Sometimes you play this on turn 2 off of Llanowar Elves, and that's all you need to win. And that's, there's a reason we play this card, even though it's not really on theme with the rest of the plan. And finally, Domri Chaosbringer. There are a couple things about Domri that make him really interesting. Being able to give our creatures haste is powerful, both with Steelleaf Champion or both with cheaply powering out a mana creature. Like, giving a Llanowar Elves haste means it's essentially free. But then also, our creature density is very high, and so Domri's downtick is extremely likely to hit you two creatures. So that's another form of sort of resilient card advantage that can keep us going. Oh yeah, and I meant to say, the reason I'm playing this in Best of One is because Best of One has far fewer sweepers. In Best of Three, we're going to run into a lot of Esper control and things like that, and our deck can technically beat Akaya's Wrath, but is going to have a very difficult time doing so. So I'm going to play it without sideboards so we don't get our creatures swept up. That's all I really have for now. I'll go ahead and hop into the games. Okay, first game with Elf Ball. Opponent is going first. We're on the draw. I'm going to keep this hand because if we draw lands, it's very good. And even if we don't draw lands, as long as our elf dies, it's quite, or our elf doesn't die, it's quite good. They might like play a mountain and shock my elf and then we're just kind of screwed. Okay, that's slightly worrying, as is drawing the absolute worst card we could have drawn. I swear anytime I keep a hand with one Growth Chamber Guardian, the seventh one is just glued to the top of my deck. The second one. Okay, Grixis Control, again, a little bit worrying. Oh god. So, this is not going super well, as you can probably tell. The black suggests that our opponent probably has Ritual of Soot in their deck. Maybe they're more of a Grixis mid-range deck, which would be good for us, but I suspect this is... Oh my god, in the main deck, really? Oh, jeez. Well... this is why you don't keep one landers even on the draw, I guess. If we start drawing lands, I think we still might be in good shape. Okay, now we are probably screwed. That's just gonna kill us too fast. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and pack it in. Alright, not a great start for Elf Ball. Yeah, not great. Okay, game two with Elf Ball. Gonna turn it around, gonna try not to die horrifically like we did last time. Okay, this game can't possibly be as bad as last time, so we have that going for us. Lost the die roll again, though, that's unfortunate. Interland Harbor tapped, huh? I'm gonna make the wild guess that this is Sultai and they have this plus basic swamp as their lands, and they're gonna play an explore creature here. Man, I am so good. Alright, drew their land, that's fine. I'm gonna go ahead and play Incubation Druid here. I could preserve our life total a little bit with Thorn Lieutenant because they can't attack into it, but I would really like to set up playing Beast Whisperer and start drawing some cards. This matchup can be tough, like they kill our one important creature, and then if we don't get anything else going, we'll kind of get run over. They don't even have double black yet, though, so it's possible that we just get to stick this guy and run away with it. Pass the turn, no whammies, please. I could have like played one of these and set up a turn where I go Beast Whisperer into another creature. Oh no! Oh, red source, please. Red source, please. I need it back. Oh man, we haven't hit red in either of these games. We don't have that many red sources, but we also don't have to hit these until significantly later in the game. Like, we don't need red on turn one or anything. Well, I think that's probably the game. We're not gonna be able to kill this easily, so they're probably just gonna run away with it. Play Beast Whisperer, then start playing Explore Creatures, and we'll just never keep up. Mana causing us issues 2 games in a row. Oh my. That's the worst thing that has ever happened to me. Yeah. Alrighty then. Alright. Game three with Elf Ball. This is probably the worst hand we've had yet. Like the lowest upside, but I really just need to start not recording with any deck that goes undefeated when I test with it, because that just seems to be a surefire recipe for getting beat up. I'm gonna go ahead and play the Growth Chamber Guardian here. Next, it looks like the opponent is probably playing a control deck. So next turn, we can apply a lot of pressure without committing too many additional resources by just taking this up. Oh, Moment of Craving. Ugh. Wow. And we're now flooding out, and this matchup probably sucks. Probably dead again. Yeah, I promise I won like 5 in a row with this deck the last time I played it, and now things are not looking great for the home team. All right, well, that's something. All right, let's get to it. Hey-ya! Please no Kaya's Wrath. Please no Kaya's Wrath. Okay, that's still quite bad for us, but that's not bad. Doing this right now so they can't respond, so I'm guaranteed to get my card out of it. Taking two so that I can hit them for one. Their life is much more valuable than mine. Dovin's Acuity, huh? Is this just like life gain control? They literally haven't done anything that didn't gain them life yet. Every single card they've played. Alright, I'm gonna do this again. Really hoping to not get Kaya's Wrathed. Maybe they'll play a creature and then Kaya's Wrath because that way it'll gain them life. Yeah, we kind of have to play into another Kaya's Wrath here. We're just not applying enough pressure with just these three. Radical idea, interesting. Another Vraska's Contempt, okay. They have gained 2, 3, 4, 7, 8, 9, 12. They've gained 14 this game. That is nuts. I think I'm going to play Domri and Downtick. Let's get up some cards. And now I'm gonna start holding on to cards. I just talked about how I wanted to commit more pressure, but the way they used a removal spell indicated to me that they do not have a sweeper. But if they do, okay, gain some life, sure. You got. Sure. Yeah, this is an interesting idea. Like, they would have been long since dead without gaining a whole bunch of life here. So, I'm gonna assume they have a removal spell. Otherwise, I could try to go for a kill with Steel Leaf Champion here. Oh, and they just pack it in. All right, one and two. Maybe bringing it back a little. Control deck didn't draw their sweeper. Pretty good for us. All right, fourth game with Elf Ball. This is okay. The problem that this deck has that other two-color tribal decks do not is that our splash cards, the reason we're playing red, is for non-creature spells. Other decks can get away with making their splash happen off of unclaimed territory. Like, if all of our red cards were creatures, we could play a bunch of unclaimed territory and have 12 red. That would be pretty good. Alright, I'm just gonna go ahead and slam this guy. If we can play another one, draw a card, and go off, we'll be in good shape. This was pretty aggressive on their part. But yeah, so unclaimed territory doesn't do anything for us. It doesn't help us. They have a cast down. Damn it! These Sultai decks play like two pieces of two mana removal tops. And we have gotten got by it a lot. Hostage Taker again? No, Karn. I can beat a Karn. We could have a Drowned Catacomb. Alright, drawn land, not so good. Drawing more land, also not so good. We're not applying that much pressure to their life total yet, so I'm just gonna hit Karn. I would like to get him off the field. I think we're gonna have to play the long game here. I could start applying pressure because we're already threatening to have a ton of mana if they can't remove our board, and maybe we just bonfire them, banefire them to death, but I would prefer to just like draw a Growth Chamber Guardian or something. Okay, now you can have a Hostage or a Hydroid Crisis. This card is causing us problems. We can kill it this time, so it's not as bad. Wow, Shimmer in your Sultai deck, huh? I feel like the one of the strengths of Sultai is that most of oh, come on! I suppose a lot of people have been playing Mono Blue, but that hurts. All right, I'm gonna blow our It sucks to blow our Banefire, but we need to stop this. We can't let them get the Hostage Taker now. Oh my gosh, we're just flooding out 7 lands out of 13 cards. It's so many in our pretty land light deck. Vivien Reach, sure. But yeah, like, since Mono Blue just won the Pro Tour, I imagine people are doing this more often, but dang, it really sucks when we're trying to play this deck over here. Hey, that was a great draw. For once, very happy that Domri puts cards on the bottom, so we still have more Growth Chamber Guardians to go get. We're gonna get to draw a lot of cards here. Oh, that's mean. Still, we'll see what they've got. Oh, come on! Well, that was terrible. Hopefully, they can't commit anything else to the board here. This looks like it's the version without a Wild Growth Walker. Vivien Reed can't be nearly as good in this version. They just don't have enough creatures. Like, look at this, their creature density is just really low. So let's see. I uptick Domri, which is definitely going to happen. Give her haste. She taps for one. When we have 7, minus 2 is 5. So then I can still adapt this. Actually gonna give her the counter, and I'm not going to I'm not going to play the Thorn Lieutenant this turn. Going to try to avoid playing too hard into a find finality. Alright, so we have... Yep, that's fine. Well, it's not actually fine. We really needed that, the Beast Whisperer to keep us going. Well, maybe not. Do I give this haste or a counter? I think I'm gonna give it a counter, so I'm really insulated from another find finality. It sucks that I don't get to apply a bunch of damage this turn, but I think their best out being cut off is worth it. Now, let's see, they can make a 6-6 Krasis here, which only trades with Steelleaf Champion and gets eaten by Thorn Lieutenant. So. Wait, let's make sure. Yeah, I've got enough mana. Now they have to block. Oh, wait. Well, they still very much want to block, but I can't give a creature a counter and haste. That's not how that works. Don't have anything else to do this turn, so we'll go ahead and activate, punch them for a lot of damage. I shouldn't have done this pre-combat, I just wasn't thinking. Alright, so we still have two Banefires in the deck, and I'm assuming those are lethal. We can make 7, 10, 11 mana. Yeah, so even if they somehow killed these two creatures, Banefire's lethal. We still have a Domri, who has done a lot of work this game. That counter was extremely relevant. Oh my gosh, Hostage Taker! This card is ruining my life. This card is... Oh dear. Another land, that sucks. See, if I make this a 6-7, it can't eat both of these. Oh god. Oh. Four creatures the first time, only one that time. I thought we were in really good shape, and then this into that, into just kind of breaking on that. Everything went south very fast. They've got a Memorial to Folly so they can get back their Hydroid Krasis and continue going off with that. They have five cards in hand. Yeah, I think we're kind of dead here. Like maybe earlier when I was fighting over Karn, I should have been more aggressive. Oh my gosh. Like, this only kills our Steel Leaf, and it'll kill one of these two, but the two counters on their creature is really relevant for us. Yeah, like, this is so ridiculously big. Oh. Yep. Just doing this because this creature is just, like, too threatening. Oh, this is a sad, sad game. Yep. Big giant monster. Well, that's one of the better things we could have drawn. Huh. We can't really protect Domri, so I'm just going to downtick him here. Like, it would be kind of cool. Oh my god. It would have been cool to give this haste so I could activate it this turn, but then he's kind of dead. That's unfortunate. Sure, put a Guardian on top. If we'd been doing this one turn earlier... Like, instead of last turn where we kind of did nothing, we might be okay, but, like, here they get their Krasis or a Hostage Taker back. It's gonna be really difficult for us to beat either of those cards. Yep. Just getting trillion for one by this hostage taker. See what they take. Yeah, I figured. That's fine. Like, Incubation Druid has been really bad here. Just hasn't been able to attack, like, at all. And also hasn't. We haven't been able to make use of all the mana. Blocks. They've already burned two finalities, so plus a cry. So. Wow, for the just for the scry, really? Okay. Guardian. Another one. And then this is actually our last one, so we can go ahead and play it out. We don't have to worry about them killing it with the activation on the stack, because that's not really a thing. So now these are really all they have going for them. Like, otherwise we're. Oh, it is not the day to be playing Elf Ball. Oh. All right. Last one. This is all my heart can take, one way or another. Either we're about to get main deck infinite sweepered again, or I don't want to give myself false hope and keep playing. This hand's too slow. We don't have any ones or twos, which is like our whole deck. All right, this is this first hand we lost with, but have we won a die roll yet? And we're against Gates. Our deck can't beat a Gates Ablaze. It's just not possible. But I suppose we can try. Which one would I rather lose? I think this is the least important creature. All right, you have one turn to Gates Ablaze me, or I'm gonna do some real gross stuff. Gatebreaker Ram, that is much more beatable. Right, so we want to figure out the order. I suppose the order doesn't really matter much, actually. So, now I'm gonna go ahead and attack with my Thorn Lieutenant, because if they block, I can grow it just off of Marwyn and beat them up that way. And if they don't block, then I'll just hit them for the three, and we can continue kind of going off here. Right, so, what do we want to do? We have 7 mana here, so we could play this and activate it to give us all the mana in the world for next turn. Or we could continue drawing cards with. Growth Chamber Guardians, try to go wide. I'm gonna set myself up for the best possible turn next turn. Okay. Now we have at least one creature who doesn't die to Gates Ablaze, so that's kind of awesome. Actually, two. This one. They can't. I suppose if they played another gate and Gates Ablazed, the Clan Caller dies, this goes down to a 3/5, and then we're kind of dead. Nope, they pack it in. All right, so 2/3 with Elf Ball. Not super spectacular. A lot of those games were pretty painful, but oh well, it was still doing something interesting, and this last game in particular, we really got to do our thing, so. That's all for this week. If you liked this, I'd love it if you can subscribe. Go ahead and hit that button below, and I'll be back on Friday with more stuff.